is to keep a high level of activity. Always.
So the regular season wall on 55 yards for Fairbairn. Went from 41 today. And in overtime, he's 3-for-3 in his career.
Yeah.
This is pressure football at its finest.
It really is.
Your season can end on the next play. That's how these guys are playing right now. The pressure and the excitement all mounted up.
So much was asked of
the
question
is about their game clock and relation to play clock. They are correct.
And the play clock was inside 10 seconds, so they reset it by rule of 10. Tell the quarterback he's got a snap, but within 10, we should be good to go.
Well, they're set up and ready to go. And with that, Watson is going to keep and carry Hyde with him for 5 yards. I was just making a point, there's so much was asked of each team here because the Texans had a good game, right? I mean, Buffalo was driving and locking him up with a big sack and that kept it at a two-possession game. It kept it 16-0. That really sparked things on the sidelines. And Watson had to come off big with key plays to keep a drive alive and just get on the board. Then all of a sudden, Buffalo had to come back and force overtime. And now both teams have half the ball in overtime. Five. Watson. And a good pitch and catch to Kenny Stills. 10 yards there. Nice rhythm with Watson and Stills.
And Stills just abuses number 29, Kevin Johnson. Dropping back in the pocket, and just an easy travel out there. He turns 29 around. Look at the poise of Deshaun Watson. Big conversion there.
Now they're marching here past midfield, trying to get Fairbairn a shot. It's high. Taking it out for about 3-4 yards there. I know the struggles in the postseason. The Texans and Coach Bill O'Brien, well aware, has been talking about what it takes and the messaging to the team this week. They, you know, for the last 5 years, they've won the AFC South, but just getting past and over these wild card games.
You got to give them a lot of credit for the second half adjustments today because they were dead, and he and Watson made the adjustments, and his team has come back, and they fought really, really hard.
Second and six here.
Watson puts up the edge. Watson survives it and then sets down to Jones. Jones inside the 40, inside the 30, inside the 20, to the 10 yard.
Ball game.
Jones, Deshaun Watson, magical 34 yards.
And the Buffalo Bills have him dead to right. Matt Milano and Neal, they bring the blitz on the outside. And he is dead to right.
Yo.
The guy that Dabo Sweeney said was the closest thing he's seen to Michael Jordan. He put the S on his chest, and he got out and made an unbelievable throw.
Two men running full speed, ran into him at the same time, and he stood up to it and came up with what is the play of the game. First and goal. And a timeout is going to be used by Houston. He has had come from behind drama before, like what he did with the College Football National Championship on the line, the 2017 National Championship. Hunter Renfro with a second remaining as Clemson became national champions for the first time since 1981. And then this play right here. Decision that let's take care of business right now. Three
3 for 3 on field goal attempts in overtime for Faribault. Coming into this game, he had never attempted a postseason field goal. Now he has a chance to win a wild card game in overtime with a 28-yard attempt. Will this cap an all-time thriller here? And a timeout will be used by Buffalo. And to consider where Houston was just lingering in that third quarter when they trailed 16-0. And the offense looked like it wasn't going anywhere.
What did we talk about? Somebody had to step up and make a play. First there was Watt, then it was Moses. And then the adjustments they made on offense. Bill O'Brien getting Deshaun Watson on the edge. Throwing the football to DeAndre Hopkins underneath. You got to give Bill O'Brien and this team a lot of credit for the guts, the heart they showed here in the second half. And J.J. Watt got it kicked off with a sack to end the drive.
The Bills have blocked 2 field goal attempts this year. Bear Baron for the win in overtime to advance the Texans. Got it! Great game in Houston. NFL 100. Perfect start to the playoffs. 22-19 in an overtime wild card classic. The Texans had been 0-22 under Bill O'Brien when trailing by 16 points in a game. They come all the way back. Buffalo punches back to the final bell. And then Faribault wins it after Deshaun Watson pulled off a magical play, staying alive to put them in position. Let's go down to the field to Lisa Salters.
Thank you, Tess. JJ. Is this why you came rush back?
This is why you come back. I don't know if I meant to come back with these many players or this much extra time, but these feelings, these emotions, these things, these players, Deshaun Watson, all the guys on this team, this is why you come back.
You guys were down 16-0, and then there was your sack, and then Deshaun started doing his thing. What changed after that?
Energy, spark. All you need is a little spark. With this team, all you need is a little bit of a spark. Give D4 a chance, and you're never out of the game.
What were you guys saying about each other, saying to each other, when you scored those 19 unanswered?
All we needed was a play, to start it. And then once it gets started, just let our guys do our thing. We have a ton of talent, a ton of guys who know what they're doing, and we got one hell of a quarterback.
You sure do. I didn't even know you were behind me, Deshaun. How in the world did you escape that sack?
Man, just never quit, honestly. I knew it was blitz zero. I checked the play. Kevin Johnson was here last year, so he knew what to say. Seen a bell, and I just tell myself to stay up. I mean, it's do or die right now. And all the work I've been putting in all season, I just had to make a play. And I told the guys before the game, I said, I put a card in that locker. I said, let's be great today. So somebody had to be great. Why not me?
Did you even see Tywan Jones make that catch?
I did. I threw it to him, and I saw him catch him when I was falling. And I just heard the crowd going crazy. I could see him running. And it was just amazing.
What did you learn about your team today, Deshaun?
We never quit, regardless. Whatever it takes to get the dub, whatever it takes to get the win, I mean, we're going to keep fighting. So, I mean, however long we have to play, we're going to keep fighting. I'm going to do my best.
Thank you. Congratulations on the win.
They had to play a long time tonight, deep into overtime. 3:20 remaining. And this was the game winner, for Taimi Faribault. 28 yards, true and true. Good operation, good hold. And then Fairbairn, that moment that all kickers dream of. Game on the line. And this one, postseason pressure. But the star tonight, the star of stars, Deshaun Watson. His second playoff start and he pulls it off. And this guy for a playoff debut, he gave us a little bit of everything. Moments early that were wow. Moments late that you shook your head. In the end, a thrilling drive to close out regulation. Josh Allen, as Bill O'Brien celebrated. And Sean McDermott knows he's heading back to Buffalo with a very strong team for the future, but this one was for the taking today. But instead, it's in the grasp of J.J. Watt and his stunning return from injury. 22-19, the Texans advance past the Bills in overtime. Of course, the Titans and Patriots still business to do on CBS.
No, I can't hear
from you. Stay tuned for the Ram Trucks postgame report coming up on SportsCenter. On ABC's Brad Paisley Dixie special is coming up after these messages, except on the West Coast. For their entire crew, I'm Joe Tessitore saying, enjoy the rest of your night, everybody. So long from Houston.
ESPN thanks you for watching this presentation of the National Football League.
Lots changed since you were here.
It's called the internet.
Finishing, not quite much shooting.
Season.